3 months after my 9th birthday, I went to see my father. I said, "Dad, I'm in trouble." My father got very concerned, and he was thinking, "Drugs?" It wasn't that. I had a problem with my employee taking me to court. Let me explain you how that happened. Just a few days before that, I declared to my father that I wanted to create my own smartphone game and become a millionaire. He smiled and replied, "Misha, relax. 9-year-old boys play games, not make them." I proudly answered, "But Dad, I'm 9 1/4. And Dad said, "Wow, you are right. That is a huge difference." Later, he gave me his account on a website called freelancer.com where you can hire developers. The first guy I hired, let's call him just in case, thought that working is all about getting rich, not doing the work. He wrote a complaint to the freelancer.com Supreme Court because I didn't want to pay him for some pictures he downloaded online. I was scared to death. £200 were frozen on my account. I got an email from the freelancer.com judge. I thought I was going to prison. I wanted to become the world's first 9-year-old millionaire, not the world's youngest prisoner. It was late night, my parents were asleep, and I had no idea what to do. But then I looked at my hand, and it wasn't shivering. I knew I wasn't scared that much. I woke up, took my laptop, and wrote a huge, honest email about what really happened to the judge. After a few days, my life's first litigation started with a big win. My first lesson: never be afraid of the cheaters. Luckily, after that, I hired a better guy called Mike. He was much more honest with everything. Everything? Except his name. Later, I found out that his real name is Mohammed. My second lesson: truly honest people are rare. On the 7th of September, 2018, I published my first game called Hit the Ball. Now, I was 100% sure I'll become the world's first 9-year-old millionaire. However, as we all know, reality betrays our dreams. Since I forgot to add in-app purchases, Hit the Ball only made me £5. But I didn't give up. I decided to make a second game with Mohammed, called Shoot Pinata. We worked hard for 4 months, and the game was loved by people all over the world. I made more than £700. This is just a little far away from a million. However, I still continue to make £100 every month. I urgently need to improve my income. If I continue at the same pace, I will only get to a million in 834 years. Download Cheat Pinata and help me before it's too late. My third lesson: never give up. Now I know what you might be thinking. This is all because of my father, Victor, who is a successful IT entrepreneur. And yes, despite his busy work schedule, he always finds time to answer my questions. However, very soon I realized that my father doesn't know everything. I discovered that you can learn anything online. I used to think that YouTube has mostly videos of other people playing games, but now although it has much more than that. There are many interesting videos on game design and business development. My fourth lesson. It is now easier than ever to learn business because of YouTube. For almost a year, I was afraid to tell Mike how old I was. But one day last year, he came to London and wanted to meet me. In the beginning of our conversation, his facial expression was like that. For the duration of our 2-hour conversation, Mike told me about game development as no other YouTube video did. I was very impressed with my worker. My fifth lesson, never be ashamed of your age. In several months after my game release, a journalist from TEDxYouth asked me for an interview. TEDxYouth is the largest news website in Belarus, the beautiful country where I'm from. I was 100% sure my dad would come with me. But one day before the interview, he left the country for a business trip. I was shocked. I was scared to death. I thought I would look like an idiot and wanted to cancel the interview. But I didn't. The journalist was asking me a lot of tough questions. But I gave the perfect interview, and not only was it heeded by 700,000 people, it also brought several thousand downloads to my game. My sixth lesson, don't be afraid to give interviews and share your product with the world. 27th of March, 2019, I will remember as one of the most difficult days in my life. One of the world's biggest game development companies, PlayGenery, launched a full copy of my game, but in different design. Now I know why their company name is so similar with the word plagiarism. They have millions of dollars of marketing budget, world's best game designers, and a lot of experience. And I was just a 9-year-old boy who was extremely upset. But I didn't give up. I was inspired by the David and Goliath story, which I read at my school. I realized I was able to pay Apple to get my game shown first when somebody searched the name of their game. After a week, Apple's search algorithm started to show my game in the search queries related to them, even without me paying Apple. I didn't beat plagiarism, Derry. But I managed to make some money from their attack. My seventh lesson, there is an opportunity in every problem. Today I'm thinking about my third game, considering all the lessons I've learned. While thinking about it, I've realized everything around us is made by entrepreneurs. My eighth lesson, entrepreneurs can make our world a better place. So, I want the world to have more entrepreneurs, which is why I'm here today. If you're still not sure whether you can succeed as an entrepreneur, look at me. I'm just a young boy. I like eating chocolate and to play Minecraft. I still believe in Santa Claus, but I have business cards with the name of my company, Zebby Studios. If I can achieve that, then so can you. My ninth and final business lesson, don't be afraid of anything. Become an entrepreneur, take risks, change the world, and download my game.